From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Hello, welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Cam Tran. Autopsy results show a New Hampshire police chief killed while on a drug raid yesterday died of a single gunshot wound to the head. State police, the FBI, and ATF agents continue to comb the crime scene where Greenland Police Chief Michael Maloney and four other officers were shot while trying to serve a search warrant at the home of 29-year-old Cullen Mutry of Post Road in Greenland. After a tense overnight standoff, Mutry and a female acquaintance were found dead inside that home. Their autopsies are scheduled for Saturday. Maloney was 48 years old and was scheduled to retire in just 8 days when he was shot to death. Two officers remain hospitalized and two were treated and released. People at Greenland say Chief Maloney was more than just a member of the town police force. He was a well-liked part of their community. Maloney stopped for coffee every morning at Suds and Soda. Store manager Bill Adams had been hiding a flyer advertising a surprise retirement party for Maloney later this month. Next Friday was supposed to be the chief's last day on the job.
He was just one terrific guy. I mean, 8 days ago.
Maloney leaves behind a wife and two kids. There is a memorial fund for the Maloney family. You can find information about that fund on our website, WMTW.com. A jury in Aroostook County Superior Court has found Thane Ormsby guilty of 3 counts of murder and the stabbing deaths of 2 men and a 10-year-old boy back in June of 2010. The jury began deliberating the case around noontime today. Ormsby had pleaded not guilty and not guilty by reason of insanity in the killing death of Jeff Ryan of Amity, Ryan's son Jesse, and family friend Jason DeHaan. The jury had also convicted Ormsby of 1 count of arson for setting fire to Jeff Ryan's pickup truck. The attorney general's office says the insanity phase of the trial will begin on Tuesday. A Lincoln County jury this afternoon found a Maine state trooper guilty on 4 counts of unlawful sexual contact, 4 counts of unlawful sexual touching, and 4 counts of assault. However, the jury found Gregory Vermin not guilty of tampering with a witness. Earlier this week, Vermin was attacked in the courtroom by a Massachusetts man and had to be hospitalized. Because of that, the reading of the jury's verdict was delayed until today and had to be moved to Bath so the courtroom in Wiscasset could be cleaned following the attack. Police in Rochester, New Hampshire have arrested this Berwick woman after a joint investigation with Profile Bank officials. Police say that Kristen Fallon made multiple withdrawals from customers' bank accounts over a 2-year period. Fallon was working at the Profile Bank at the time. She has been charged with 1 count of felony unauthorized taking. Both the Maine House of Representatives and the State Senate have signed off on a budget rewrite. The budget would cut the state's reimbursement to municipalities for general assistance from the current maximum of 90% to 85%. The governor wanted deeper cuts but stopped short of a threatened veto. Lawmakers are expected to return in May to complete budget work on the Department of Health and Human Services budget. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Cam Tran. Stay with us for the latest weather, sports, and highlights. We'll be right back.